All right, so guys, doing a revision on everything that is agriculture income and exempt income. That is a chapter that we've just finished. Doing this revision, I'm going to upload it so that you can watch it whenever you want to revise it. It'll be a quick revision. Participate, because that's also going to be recorded, whatever you participate in and as. All right, agriculture income and exempt income, both are really happy. Why are they happy, guys? Because they don't have to pay any taxes under which section, guys? Under section 10, we'll first start with agriculture and then we'll move to exempt income. Agriculture income is exempt under which section? 10.1. And for that, lands can be classified into two parts: rural agriculture land and urban agriculture land. Guys, rural is in which area? Very obvious question. And urban is in urban area. Rural, guys, first let's discuss what is agriculture income. Guys, what if I cultivate and sell? But it should be agricultural produce. What if I don't have the time and I rent it out? Exempt, but it should be for what purpose? Agri. What if I have income from farm building? Now, what is a farm building, guys? If your farm is in Bangalore, your farm building can't be in Calcutta. It should be in the vicinity. And typical income from farm building is like renting it for godown, etc. Is that also exempt? Yes. Growing flowers, creepers, seedlings, saplings, also exempt, guys. But here, guys, seedlings, saplings, even if the primary operations are not done on land, still it will be exempt. Guys, sale of such rural agriculture land, it's not agriculture income. But it's not even capital gain, so it's not taxable. That's rural. Now, what about urban agriculture land, guys? Urban is the same way, except two things, guys. What are the two things? Same taxability, except SB. S means sale of urban agriculture land. Is it taxable? Yes. And farm building, guys. Because now both are in urban areas, can you put a PG available board? And can you sell the urban agriculture land for a high price? So the government says in both cases, these will be taxable. Now that we know what is agriculture income and how is it exempt, can we now see what is urban area? Guys, urban area depends on population. Is that true?
Yes.
And it does not end at municipal limits. It goes ahead. How ahead, guys? If a place has a population of more than 10 lakhs. Municipal limits plus 8 kilometers. Population is more than 1 lakh up to 10 lakh. Then municipal limits plus? If a smaller town, guys, of more than 10,000 up to 1 lakh, then in that case, municipal limits plus, and if it's a really tiny town up to 10k, guys, then in that case only the municipal limits plus how many kilometers? Nothing else, guys. Zero. That is urban area. Anything beyond that? What if I'm on 862 exact? Urban. Beyond that is rural. Nice, guys. Moving ahead to two incomes, guys. Sometimes we do activities which involve both agriculture and PGBP. What is that called? Composite incomes. In case of composite incomes, everyone, what is the first composite income that you know? Excellent. Tea. And is there agriculture also? And is there PGBP also? Guys, how many cups of tea would you want to have in a day? 8. So rule 8 says how much is PGBP? How much is agriculture? Next is rule 7B, which is for what business? Guys, in this case, 40% and 60 is obvious, guys. You have to only remember PGBP. But if the coffee is only grown and only cured, then it's 20%, 25 and 75. This is only grown and cured. All right. Next, guys, what is the next business? Rubber business. In rubber business, what is the rule, guys? 7A. In this case, it will be 35% PGBP. And guys, all these divisions will be of sales, expenses or profit. Profit. So you have to first get the final number and then divide it. And guys, what if I have a potato farm and a chips factory? Which is exempt? Which is taxable? So where would I ideally want to show more profits, guys? Here. Because more profits means no taxes. And here, guys, low profits means low taxes. So I can manipulate. But the government says, enough. I know how you manipulate. So now if you transfer, as per rule 7, it should only be transferred at what value, guys? So what if I don't know the market value? Cost plus profit. And guys, whatever is one person's sales will be the other person's cost. Are we clear with this, guys? This is composite income. And guys, even though people are very happy earning agriculture income, is there a scam going on?
Yes.
Do you know the scam?
Yes.
It's called scam of partial integration, or the scheme of partial integration. Is it applicable, or can it be applicable to you? Yes, because first condition, you should have a... How many people have a basic exemption limit? 4. Please tell me which one. Individual, HUF, AB. AOP and BOI, we call it AB and? and AJP. In these four cases, guys, can it apply? But for it to apply, second condition, guys, you should enjoy the best of both incomes. Agriculture income more than how much? 5,000. And taxable income more than how much, guys? Basic exemption limit. That's the reason, guys, I am not subject to the scheme as of now because I don't have agriculture income. The moment I have agriculture income, net agriculture income more than how much? 5,000, I'll be taxed. Guys, what is agriculture income? Not your 10 lakh. 10 lakh minus your cost, that is your net agriculture income. Yes? And how do you calculate this tax liability, guys? Step one, shock. Take your exempt income, agriculture income plus taxable income and calculate on 16 lakh. Let's assume, guys, that is 3 lakh. Assumption. Which tax will you take? A, B, and C. That means basic tax, surcharge, and cess. Total tax liability. Step two, calm down. So 10 lakhs agriculture income plus basic exemption limit, assuming 12.5 lakhs on this, guys, it is, let's assume it is 2 lakh. So how much will you land up paying? 1 lakh, that's your tax liability. Most people don't get this in the exam right because the exam never tells you it's OP. It'll just tell you agriculture income is there, taxable income is there. They will just tell you find out tax liability. And what do you have to assume, guys? This is something that you should know that you have to use it. Are we okay? Guys, this is agriculture income. Moving on to the next one, which is exempt income. Everyone, moving on to the next one, which is exempt income. Guys, exempt incomes is in section 10. What is the difference between exemption and deduction? Exemption doesn't enter your taxable room only. And deduction enters, goes till GTI, and then it's deducted. So section 10.1 is for what? Agriculture. Section 10.2 is share of income of members of HUF. Because HUF has paid taxes. 10.2a, share of profit of partners of partnership firm LLP, because they have paid taxes. 10.4.2, interest earned in which account, guys? NRE account. By whom? Non-residents. You know, guys, even if they become residents, will it still be exempt? Yes. 10.6.2. Guys, shortcut, how many people came from France or foreign government to India? 62. And guys, just like we are taxing our people abroad, they will tax their. So if they are taxing their people, what do we have to do? Exempt them. Next, guys, 10.10 BC. What is BC? Big calamity. In that case, guys, are you getting some money? Yes, in that case, you're getting some money and that will be exempt. Next, 10.10 D. Of course, there's one 10.6.7 also, which we'll see tomorrow in residential status chapter. 10.10 D is death. If you receive some money from life insurance, guys, then is it exempt? In which two cases? Death and when all the premiums are low. And when is it taxable, guys? When even one of the premium is high. So what is this high and what is this low, guys? If you've taken the policy before 1/4/2012, up to 20% is low. And on or after that? It depends on premium payment or policy taken date. Policy taken. And for disabled person, this has changed from 1st April 2013, it's 20 has become 15. All right. Next, guys, is 10.11a. What is this? Sukanya Samridhi. Remember, 11 rupees in the Sukanya Samridhi account. On payment, you get a deduction, which we'll see in deduction chapter. But this is receiving the money. Is that exempt? Yes. 10.12a and 10.12b. Guys, which account? NPS account. NPS account, National Pension Scheme, is for what purposes? Retirement. Don't remove it in between. If you remove it in between, will we add it to your income? Yes. And will we give you an exemption? Yes. Only 25% of what? Self-contribution. Only 25%, guys. And what if you remove after? Then still we will tax you, but we will get you an exemption of 60% of total amount. That is NPS. Next, guys, 10.15. If you open, who gives you 15% interest rate, guys? Post office. Just the shortcut. If post office savings scheme gives you interest, how much of it is exempt? 3,500 for single person and multiple joint holders, 7,000 aggregate. 10.16. Scholarships received from government approved sources, exempt. 10.17. 17 allowance received by whom? MPs, MLAs are also exempt. 10.18. How many gallantry awards? 18. But we're not talking about the awards. The award winners, when they get pension, that is exempt. Great, guys. 10.19. Armed forces, guys, when they get family, because unfortunately they are no more, so a family pension is exempt. Guys, where is the next holiday, guys, and how many days? Above for 26 days. Sikkimese individuals, which income is exempt? Any income from within Sikkim, also dividend income anywhere in India. 10.32. Minor child clubbing, how much will be exempt? A huge amount, 1,500 per minor child per annum whose income is club. 1034, I'm so sorry guys, this is not there. All the shareholders feel bad about it. Dividend income is no longer exempt. Is it taxable? Yes. But because of that, the Indian companies have given a new benefit, 1034A. In buyback, guys, who makes the money? Shareholders. But who pays the tax? And hence, shareholders are exempted. They are very happy with this. This is a reciprocal arrangement. Next, 1037. Urban agriculture land. What if you sell it? Taxable. But what if it's compulsory acquired? Exempt, guys, but it's only available to whom? Individuals and HUFs, and only available if you use for what purposes, guys? For how many years? Agricultural purpose, last 2 years. And guys, do you want to sit back, relax, and only eat, chill, repeat? Yes, 1043 section gives you that option. Reverse mortgage scheme. And this scheme, guys, who pays you the money? Bank. Against mortgage of what papers? Property papers. Guys, it's a loan or is it income? You have to repay it back. How will the bank get it back? Either you repay or they'll sell the house, guys. But that is a reverse mortgage, that is exempt, 1043. Something which is not an exemption, guys, is a deduction. We discussed one deduction, which is awesome area, 10AA. It is given only to which units? So what if there is DTA unit? Ignore it. SEZ unit, if they export, will they get some benefit? For how many years, guys? 15 years. First 5 years. Next 5 years. And next 5 years, 50% or amount contributed to reinvestment reserve account, whichever is less. Every year you have to calculate one shortcut, guys. What is that? Export percentage profit. What is this export percentage profit? Let me just put it here. Export percentage of which unit? So if they've exported 40 crores divided by total 100 crores, how much is the export percent? 40. Into profit of which unit? Everything of which unit, guys? SEZ. So how much is your exemption? 12 crores. Sorry, deduction is 12 crores. First 5 years, how much percent? 100. Entire 12 crores. Next 5 years? Of course, the numbers will change every year. You do a fresh calculation. This is just for illustration purposes. And last 5 years, 50% or the amount contributed into which account? RRA. That account has to be used for what purposes? Reinvestment within how long, guys? 3 years. If you don't utilize it, tax. If you misutilize it. And guys, do you have to be fit? Yes. Freight, insurance, telecom charges. Guys, if they are charged to your clients abroad and they are appearing in sales, what do you need to do? Excluded from sales. And guys, 10AA means will income go in PGBP first? Yes. Whether it's SEZ unit or DTA unit, will it go in PGBP first? Yes. Then will it come in a funnel down? Yes. And then guys, will you minus it under which section? 10AA. Awesome area, awesome revision. Thank you so much, guys. Good night.